Hi, I'm Jared with Fun Science Demos. In a previous video, we highlighted these. They're called reaction rockets, and they're perfect to talk about the transfer of energy. When I drop the rubber ball, it propels the rocket upward, and today we're going to try and make our very own reaction rockets. So let's pull this apart and just take a closer look at all the different parts of our reaction rocket. We have some kind of stem, which looks like it's just a hollow straw, with our bouncy ball. Then we have a bigger straw and some tubing that's going to weight the end of my rocket. So next we need to gather some materials that we could substitute and make our own rocket. So we've gathered some materials. Now let's start trying to test these out to see which ones work best. Let's start with the bouncy ball. We got some of these balls from the dollar store, some of them from online, some from even gumball machines. Now this is going to provide the elastic energy that's going to propel my rocket upward. So let's test some of these out to see how well they bounce. This one right here, it doesn't bounce that well. This ball is much heavier. I have a better bounce. This one's more squishy. Still has a good bounce. Let's try some of these. Nice bounce. Maybe not as good as this one. So I could actually start to rate and rank which balls bounce the best and test them out and measure. Make sure you're dropping them from the same height so you can compare. Let's do these. This one looks like it's a little better. So let's compare these two. This one looks like it's a little better. Let's try this one. Ooh, that's a nice bounce. Let's try a smaller one. That's a nice bounce. So once you've identified your elastic bouncy ball, now it's time to try and figure out the stem here and the rocket. So we're gonna look at all of these materials. And I have skewers, wooden skewers, some toothpicks, coffee stirrers, straws with different diameters. These are paper straws, and these are plastic stirrers. So we tested out all these balls, we measured how high they bounced, and this one seems to be our best one. Now we need to figure out how to make this launch rod that's going to attach to the ball. And to do that, we're just going to use a thumbtack. Now you want to try and find the center of the ball. And it's also interesting to note how these bouncy balls are made. Sometimes they're seamed together. So if I'm going to push this thumbtack right at the seam, it could separate. So keep that in mind. That's all a part of science. So I'm going to identify the center. It's easier to keep the ball down on a flat surface. Find the center of the ball, and all I'm going to do is push the thumbtack down into the ball. That's it. It does help if you wiggle the thumbtack a little bit to make the hole bigger. And now I'm ready to put a skewer, a wooden skewer, into the ball. Now you want to make sure your skewer is straight. Sometimes these have a little bit of a curve, so sort through them and pick a nice straight skewer. Here we go. Pull out the thumbtack. Line up your skewer. I sometimes twist a little bit as I push it in. You don't want to push it too far because the ball could actually split apart. Now let's test it out. Yep, it bounces. Now this wooden skewer is a little bit long, and to cut this, I could try to use my scissors, but we've always found it helpful to just get a pair of pruning shears that you use in the garden. You can measure this. Just cut down this. Now, if I wanted this to look similar to this with that black launch rod, I could simply use a coffee stirrer. That's gonna give me a more identical look. You're gonna see that fits in just the same. I'm gonna try the skewer. Now it's time to make the rocket that's going to slide over our launch rod and be propelled upward. Now it's time to build the rocket. And to build the rocket, we're going to use straws. Straws do come in different diameters and sizes. This is a thinner plastic straw, a thicker plastic straw, and I'm even going to try a paper straw. Now my rocket, I could measure this and have it about the same size, but there's really no need to measure exactly. You just want to make sure I have a little bit of stem that I can grab. So I'm going to make these rockets all the same size so I can measure and compare which one launches the highest. So I have a thin straw, put it right next to that. There's my thicker straw, and now paper straw. So let's test this out. You can see on this rocket I have some weight on the top. Let's just see if we can get a bounce just by putting the straw over it. Whoa, I got a double bounce. It seemed to launch on the second bounce, which is interesting. This straw is thinner diameter, so it doesn't have as much wiggle room. That one did not work well at all. Try it again. Doesn't seem to launch off of there. This one. A little bit better with the paper. So obviously I need to do something with these rockets to make them launch better. So if I look at my rocket, I have some foam fins on the bottom. I think it's just for decoration. And then I have this piece of tubing which adds weight to the top. So let's try to add some weight to the top of our straw rockets and see what happens. And well, we need to add some weight to the top. And to add weight, I could use a nut that I have in the drawer, or I could even use tape. This one's a little more complicated, so we'll start with that one first. I'm gonna need some duct tape. You'll notice when I take this straw, it's a little bit smaller than the nut. The nut just slides right down. So I need to increase the diameter of the straw by wrapping some tape around that straw. So let's just cut off some duct tape and wrap the end of this straw. So we've zoomed in so you could see how I've wrapped the end of the straw. I made that straw outer diameter a little bit bigger, so now when I try to put the nut on, I can actually twist it on. It's going to stay in place. So let's see how this one launches. So let's give this a test launch, slide it onto our launch rod, hold it up. Whoa, way better. Now these rockets are a lot of fun to launch, but there's a lot of science going on. There are a lot of variables that we can play with to take a look at and see if we can make this launch better. How high we drop this rocket from will determine how high our rocket goes, and we can measure that. We could have a ruler or a meter stick right next to us and determine which heights give us a different height for our rocket. We can also look at how high our ball is bouncing when I don't have a rocket on it. Take a look. It's coming up to about here. When I put the rocket on, Do not look at the rocket. I know this is going to be hard to look at. Don't look at the rocket going up. Look at how high the ball bounces. You can see that ball is not bouncing as high. It's only coming up that high. Well, why? Because that energy of the falling ball is transferred into the rocket. So there's not as much energy in the ball to make the ball bounce as high. Now, because these straws are wider, it's much harder to attach the metal nut. So we're gonna show you what to do. How do you add weight without that metal nut? We're gonna use tape. Any tape would work. This is a heavier duct tape and it usually works the best to do that. Just wanna tear yourself a length. You could tear it. It's easier if you cut it. And then what I like to do is stick part of it to a desk, come in with your scissors, and you don't need the whole width of that tape. I can cut it in half by just simply going down and tearing the rest. And now I'm going to take this tape and wrap it around the top part of my straw rocket. You do want to make sure it's pretty straight. You don't want the tape to kind of come off the end of that straw where it could actually stick to your launch rod. Now the nice part about this is I can keep adding rolls to that tape to change the weight of this rocket. And if I had a scale, I could actually measure the mass of this rocket and really do some great science and data collection to see if I can find a difference to how high that rocket flies based on its weight. So there we go. We have the top weighted. Let's see, this is the paper straw. You can see it doesn't ride as smoothly. So I'm gonna look at this end, inspect, because one of the part of the end of that straw was curled in and giving me extra friction. Now, yeah, I have a good bounce there. 3, 2, 1. I get a good launch. So now we added tape to the wider plastic straw. Let's see what kind of launch we get out of this one. 3, 2, 1. And we get another good launch. Just to get a good comparison, I'm going to try dropping this from low. I got a nice launch. I'm gonna try and dropping it from a little higher. And that almost hit the ceiling. Now, while these are just fun to launch and have fun, the science really gets exciting when you start collecting data and measuring everything. When you measure how high these rockets go and then try to make changes to your rocket to see if you can make it go higher, that's what science is all about. If you want to learn more about forces in motion or other STEM design challenges, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, especially when you can build a rocket in your classroom.